how great to be back in Berlin, the greatest city on earth, of course, with so many old friends, including Thomas, of course, who was, in fact, my sometime landlord here in the city. I was, in fact, there on the East Village in 1987, watching him do Madonna in German. And it is, I have to say, he does regularly do it in Kreuzberg a couple of years ago, is the last time I saw it, but maybe he doesn't want that public. I'm here to announce, very happily, the European film of 2015. The six films that are nominated in this category are incredibly successful in their own right, and they've been incredibly celebrated, not just here in Europe, but around the world, with festivals and audiences. To pick one winner out of them seems, may I say, almost criminal, given how successful they've all been and how individual they all are. But that's what the Academy has had to do. Before I tell you who's won European Film of 2015, what we're going to do is we're going to invite some folk who have been involved in the production of those films to come and talk to you and introduce the clips from those films. So here, I'm now going to introduce them, and here is Jane Leung from A Pigeon That Sat on a Branch Reflecting on Existence. Here she is. Siggy C. Johnson from Rams. Angeliki Papolia from Lobster. Burak Yigit from Mustang. Robert Zedhala from Youth. And Strola Brent Grovden from Victoria.
Patience. That is a word that has been very central to me during my 6 years with Roy Anderson. Up till now, patience has not exactly been one of my best qualities. I like things fast and straight. But now, I have learned all about patience. And above all, about being patient with Roy. Things should take the time they take. Roy needs the time to feel it out, to rethink, to change his mind, and then maybe change his mind again. I'm grateful that I have learned this from Roy. It's not about getting things done as quickly as possible. It's about allowing things to take the time to take in order to achieve the best possible result.
Det går ju så långsamt. Det ser ut som du sover när du går.
Det gör jag inte alls. Vi vill att folk ska vara trevligt.
When I was asked to play a greengrocer in Turkey, I thought, well, that's something mainstream, a greengrocer, finally some normal guy. Then I had an appointment and Skype is Deniz, and she said, the cast I am playing with are all girls. I thought, I like girls even better. After I read the script and it was, bam, I started to get really nervous that Deniz might cast someone else. Mustang would be an ambitious revolution of Turkish cinema. I wanted the part. And today I'm here, a grateful greengrocer, honoring one of the most beautiful pictures about dark human habits, a white act which fights for the freedom of women today in Turkey and in the rest of the world.
Sofradan. I worked in many films in Iceland, but this film, Rams, has a special meaning for me. The film is about two brothers who haven't spoken to each other in 40 years. And maybe the message of this film is that we should communicate more to create a better world. If, or I don't know if Rams is going to win here tonight or not, but I know if this film will bring a little bit more love to our world, that will be our biggest prize.
Shooting of a lobster took place in Southern Ireland. We spent several weeks in an isolated hotel and a forest nearby, which were also the main locations of the film. Without contact with any urban civilization for several weeks, we indirectly experienced the same conditions as the story's characters. We were sleeping in the same rooms, we were walking in the same corridors, we had breakfast every day at the hotel's main dining hall, and we spent days and nights in the woods of the loners. Fiction became reality, and there were times that we were convinced that when we turned our heads to the left, it meant I love you more than anything in the world, and when we turned our heads to the right, it meant watch out, we are in danger. This experience was terrifying, unbearable, unique, and above all, great.
Your last relationship lasted how many years?
Around 12.
Do you remember how long exactly, sir?
11 years and 1 month.
We've developed a code so that we can communicate with each other, even in front of the others, without them knowing what we are saying. When we turn our heads to the left, it means, I love you more than anything in the world. And when we turn our heads to the right, it means, watch out, we're in danger.
P.P. Longstockings once said something like, I've never tried that before, so I am pretty sure that I will be able to do that. And I think that this quote makes a lot of sense for the way we approach the film Victoria. I was terrified when I realized that we were just moments away from shooting a whole feature film in one single take. But with the confidence and attitude of Pippi, director Sebastian Schipper, made that experience into an amazing experience and a wonderful film. The story of Victoria unfolds in real time for 2 hours and 15 minutes, exactly as it unfolded in front of my eyes one early morning in April 2014.
What's your name?
Victoria.
Victoria, I'm Manzano. Nice to meet you.
Zola.
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 We are not Zubitzunga, we are real Berlin guys. Smoke a giant.
Peace.
Peace.
Shut the fuck up.
Hey, John. Warte doch mal.
Scheiße. Was ist das für eine Scheiße? Ich spreche kein Deutsch.
We shot a film in the Swiss Alps. During breaks, I sometimes saw Paolo Sorrentino standing somewhere. He would just stand there, smoking, staring into the distance. There's a lot of distance in the Swiss Alps. So I saw him and I wondered, what is that man thinking right now? I never found out. But I believe the truth is, Paolo Sorrentino is not thinking at all while standing there smoking, gazing out over the mountains. He's composing. He allows images to take shape in his mind. And he arranges these images, giving them rhythm, melody, harmony. That's music. I don't know how he does it, but he does it. And that is why Paolo's film Youth is so deeply moving in a way only music can be.
Six extraordinary films. One has to be chosen, and the winner for the European Film of 2015 is Youth.
Thank you very much. It's a great, great honor. Thank you to the Academy, I forgot to tell. And this is a small movie about the perception of the freedom that we have. And I am very happy that this movie received an award, because the most important thing now in Europe is exactly this, the perception of the freedom that we will have. Sorry for my English. Thank you very much.
Thanks to the jury, thank Paolo, who has chosen to work with us for many years, and thanks to him, we on this stage for the second time in 2 years. And I'd like to say hello to my friend, my partner, Nicola Giuliano. And from this stage, I want to say that Youth is a European co-production. And I think we should, all of us, we should work to hard and more to increase and to facilitate the European co-production, any kind of co-production for arty movie, for low budget movie, but also for mainstream and for high budget films for the youngest audience of the future. Thank you.
Just a big thank you to all our partners. As Francesca said, it's a European co-production. So a thank you to Barbary Films, to Number 9, to C Films in Switzerland, to Eurimage for their continuous and precious support. And obviously also for our to all our Italian partners. And obviously, last but not least, to Paolo.
I'd just like to say thank you for the job. And next time, I'll ask for more money.